Yes, guys, Brock here. We're here at Collector's Cave today for Fez's episode of the Kurb series, where he's got 1 minute to find three vinyls, take them back to the studio, and sound Fez. Thank you.
I'm nervous. Excited but nervous.
Fez now has 1 minute to find two vinyls from down here. Ready? Three, two, one. Three, two, one, and...
I've actually got three, so I'm going to have to put one back. Actually, I've got four.
You've got four? You can't take four, lad.
I'm not taking four. So I picked up a Mike Oldfield plate. It's got like seven tunes on it, or eight tunes. Quite a few instrumentals. It was in the ambient section, so I feel like I'll get something good out of here. It might not be perfect, but there'll definitely be at least something. Random soul plate that I found downstairs. I've never heard of this in my life. Got no clue what's on here. But hopefully it's something good. That's the thing with most of these. No one's got any clue what's on them, unless you actually heard it, which I haven't yet. So. Then I've just got two random reggae plates, which I also haven't heard, funnily enough. So, there you go.
So, that's a good question. I mean, my mind's always full of interesting ideas, and Ben has some great ideas as well. But in terms of moving forward, so recently we just set up a new business called Cave Electronics. Because originally Collector Cave was just we'd sell everything and anything, antiques, clothes, you name it. Cups and saucers and glasses, and then that stuff kind of, we got bored of it. So long story short, we separated out the vinyl, CDs and tapes and just kept this very focused on music. And then the electronics, which kind of are half the business at the moment, we've decided to set up a much more focused business around hi-fi. So downstairs, our office is going to be turned into a hi-fi showroom. This is all going to be records, CDs and tapes up here. Downstairs is going to be a hi-fi showroom, which you get to through the stairwell there when it's reinstated. And then at the back, we're building a business doing repairs. So we will have three businesses, and a fourth is on the way, which is going to be toys and collectibles and kind of memorabilia, which we also do. So that's going to keep us busy for the next couple of years.
Yeah.
The other thing we're toying with is the idea of doing a record label.
Brilliant.
Kind of makes sense.
Yeah.
But it's also a very, very tricky thing to do. You know, if you're doing that just as a full-time job, it's a real big thing to take on. Very risky, as you'll probably know yourselves. Yeah. So that's longer term one of the plans we've got. So I think that'll keep us busy for the next couple of years for sure.
Yeah. Fantastic.
And obviously to make some money as well, because at the moment I pay myself, and me and Ben pay ourselves such an appalling wage.
Yeah.
It's time to take some proper money out of the business, but we have to make some first.
Yeah.
So yeah, that's why we're doing this, is just kind of get the word out and you know, build a hub for the community, because that's pretty much the beating heart of what we're about.
So we're back in the domain of Blake, and we're ready to start producing and listening to the music that we've picked up, so we're going to see how it goes. So we've got the Mike Oldfield Discovery in the Lake EP.
Yo!
Mike Oldfield, you're not pulling through. I don't know what he's done here. This is actually taking the pace. Here we've got Roots Man, it's a little label, Herb Tree. Both tracks are Herb Tree. One's got Charlie Brown, one doesn't, so maybe one of them is usable. Who knows? We'll find out.
Because the cess are the original growing seed.
Oh! Herb Tree, growing in my garden.
Real man!
Hot cold, one more the girl they want to match for. They take the water that plant.
There's a lot of stuff going on in the track, other than just the vocals, and obviously the vocals is the bit that I want. So, might be tricky, might work. Who knows? We'll give it a try. We've got Gal Gorgon, Bobo General, Dub Gorgon, Jazzwood. Nice. Let's see what it sounds like.
Yeah, man. I mean, Bobo, the original lover boy there, man. So well. Oh, God. Take time out, girls. I know you're styling. Yeah, man. Be number one. Me Bobo General and Dan.
All right, cold trim. Bobo
original, original. Oh,
that looks good. Where'd you get it from? I need a trim bad.
Like, Men's Cave, like, by near the Crown. All right, down to the last vinyl. This is a soul one. We've got 5 tracks total. Actually, wait, it might be 10. Yeah, I think we've got 10 tracks total, so this is the last hope now. We've got some good bits so far, but maybe we can find even more on this one. This one's for you. There's a lot of vinyl crackles, so I'm gonna try and take it away if I can. Isolate the instrumental from the crackling, but maybe we can hide it under a break. I'm thinking about maybe starting with like this sort of ambient, like solely R&B-ish intro,
yeah,
and then moving into the ragga jungle But we'll see if we can make it work. I'm probably gonna have to like isolate the vocals, but yeah, if it doesn't work, then it doesn't work. You can't force it to work. So the tune is now mostly finished. It's gonna have to be we've run out of time, unfortunately. We only had a couple of hours, so you know. But we'll finish it off at some point very shortly. So throughout the tune, I used one sample from the oh god, what was it? It was
the ambient one.
Yeah, the ambient plate. It was the Mike Oldfield one. It was not looking good to start with, but we managed to pull through. There was one good sample in there, and it worked out. It's like the primary sample. Taken some vocals from the ragga plates I got as well. And I think I did use the soul and funk one as well for like some layers, and I took some pads as well, the ambience in it. Overall, I'm pretty happy with it so far. It's obviously not quite finished, like the mix down, some of these work, whatnot, but it's getting there. And I think based on the conditions we're working with, I think we've done all right. So yeah, Massive thanks to Kurb for having me down. The tune is going to be available on Bandcamp and SoundCloud, but probably by the time you're watching this. So yeah, big ups to Kurb again. Thank you guys.